Tonight, the families of George Floyd and Emmett Till, two people whose deaths have become inextricably linked to the civil rights movement in the United States, now bonding over shared tragedies, tragedies that took place 65 years apart. And Sara Sidner is back with me for this powerful story.
We out here, we're thriving.
That's right.
We're gonna be on a mission.
That's right.
And we out here for justice, man.
The moment they met in Minneapolis, a bond was formed.
Ooh. I understand.
A bond born of the deepest sorrow.
Do you know how hard that is for somebody to look at their child beaten to death? Do you know how hard it is for people to look at a person who has been tortured to death over 9 minutes? It's not right.
Each experienced a violent death in the family that became a catalyst for civil rights in America. Philonis Floyd is the brother of George Floyd. Deborah Watts is the cousin of Emmett Till. They met because Watts lives in Minneapolis and took to the streets after George Floyd was killed.
Oh my God.
Look at it, man. I think about that all the time. I think about Emmett, and I was like, Emmett was like, to me, like one of the first George Floyds that people just recognized, like they put him in the spotlight, but he didn't get justice.
Didn't. He still hasn't.
He still hasn't.
But we're still fighting.
We're fighting.
I don't want you to have this 66-year journey. I really don't.
For Watts, the pain has spanned generations. Her 14-year-old cousin, Emmett Till, was murdered in 1955 by white supremacists. Till's mother opened the casket at his funeral so the world could see the horror done to her child at the hands of hateful adults.
And by making those efforts, opening Emmett's casket, showing the world what his 14-year-old body looked like with a 75-pound cotton gin fan tied around his neck with barbed wire after being thrown into the Tallahatchie River, she exposed to the world. And I think the world stood up. The world spoke out. The world was enraged.
I can't breathe. I can't breathe.
65 years later, the world spoke up again, from Minneapolis to London.
Please. Please, I can't breathe.
After watching Philonis Floyd's brother, George, gasping for air, his neck pinned down under the knee of an officer who refused his pleas for help.
People should die of natural causes, not because you're getting an overdose of a knee to someone's neck, not because you're beating somebody to death and dumping them in a river.
Both families' pain playing out in the spotlight, both creating a wave of change and demands for justice for all in America. In Floyd's case, cell phones and body cameras captured the incident of the white police officer kneeling on his neck for 9 minutes and 29 seconds. He is awaiting his fate from a jury of his peers. But the people who disfigured and murdered Emmett Till were acquitted by an all-white jury. They confessed to their crime a year later. Watts is still fighting for justice.
This is what you're going to do. It does carry some disappointments, but it also carries a lot of hope. Justice is going to be served in George Floyd's case, whether it's in the courtroom or outside of the courtroom. Justice is going to be served.
The tragedies in their lives propelled both Watts and Floyd into lifelong work they didn't intend to take on. Both have started foundations to create healing and change through policy.
The Emmett Lewis Till Victims Recovery Program is something that we're fighting for that affects the families.
I'm the big brother now.
Philonis testified in front of Congress right after his brother's funeral. At this very moment, the Floyds are trying to get the George Floyd Justice in Policing Act pushed through Congress. Both families say this is the fight of their lives for a better, more just America.
Thank you for your strength.
So you see that bond there, and let me tell you that when we left and our cameras left, we went back to pick up a couple more things, and they were still talking to each other. They hadn't separated for 40 minutes. Wow. It was a beautiful thing to see.